But looking ahead to the next two games, the next one game really, the whole talk about 3-0 down means for both New Zealand and India, it's about getting the squad right in terms of everyone getting a chance to try and perform or try and get into that World Cup squad.
So yes, I don't know what the situation with Shami is, whether they want to rest Shami a little bit more. We saw just a little bit of Khalil and said you can't read too much because the batsmen are going after you, but he was bowling short. If Dhoni is fit, of course Dhoni has to play, but I would still keep Shubman Gill in the side. He looked all right, you know. Shubman Gill, he made 8-9 runs, but there was something about him. He looked all right. I'd really like to see Shubman Gill again because he opens for Punjab. If he gets a really good game in, with KL Rahul struggling again today, as you said, he got a first ball duck again today. So maybe that third opener slot is open. I want to see a little bit more of Shubman Gill.
Also, from the bowler's perspective, we were expecting one of the Kulcha pairing to be rested today. They weren't. They both played. Jadeja still didn't get a game. So in the fifth game, do you reckon that maybe Kuldeep gets a rest and get Jadeja in?
I think both the wrist spinners will be playing is what my feeling is. Simply for the reason that lately, in the last couple of series, they've not been playing together again. You know, so India has been trying to move away from that combination. Now they've been again creating that impact in the middle over. So you would want to continue with that because now we are reaching that stage where the experimentation with regard to the combinations will be lesser and lesser. So one game to go. Shami, I feel would be rested for sure. He has been playing consistently. He's not missed many games. So that will be taken into consideration by the management. Shubman Gill, again, I'm completely with Harsha on that. I think he's looked good. Even though today's conditions were tough and he doesn't have score to show it to people that he's right there, but he looked comfortable. You know, whatever he's played today, 20 deliveries on the up, played that drive. You know, on a good track, it would have been probably 4. Played that bouncer also, you know, which hit him on the head. He was actually early in the shot. So those are the good signs. He can be creating that impact at this level. Just needs some more opportunities.
Also, from the point of view of looking at Khalil, yes, he didn't get enough overs to bowl. So does that mean you give him one more game? Because in Australia, you had Siraj 1, Khalil 1.
Look, if the decision today to play Khalil over Siraj was because he's rated above, he's above in the pecking order. If that was the reason they played him and not Siraj, then that should be the reason he plays the next game.
Right. Or if they're 50-50, then you say Siraj gets the next game?
I don't know. Look, how many did he bowl today? He bowled 3 overs for 19. I don't know if you can draw conclusions from that. That's for the on-field captain to decide. Whether the on-field captain saw something there that said he doesn't belong. If that is what Rohit Sharma thinks, because you see from the body language, you see from the approach, there's something you can't see on television, something you can see on the ground. So if Rohit Sharma thinks that, yeah, they're theek nahi hai, then you play Siraj, otherwise you play Khalil again. That would be my view. But I would definitely play Shubman Gill again.
Just to finish off with the game, on expected lines, for once there was going to be no arguments about the man of the match. The left arm quick gets the man of the match. But overall, just to look at the figures there, 20 over 6 maidens, 8 for 47. He had support at the other end. Brilliantly as he bowled, there were two bowlers who bowled in tandem and these figures really were responsible for 92 all out.
Well, he finished his quota of 10 overs as well in this 30-over game, that particular innings. Also, with Trent Bolt, you know, he has looked good right throughout the series. Today was the conditions also which worked in his favour. The ball was swinging nicely. And when you take those wickets and ball has not been beaten enough by the top order batsman, that stays new as well. So that's why it was swinging for a bit longer than normal. And the swing has always been there. And the lengths which he bowled was very important. You know, he understood the fact that he has to keep thinking wickets. And the length also, when you see that pitch map, you know, you'll see that more often than not, he was hitting that fuller length. So when the conditions are like this, you err on the fuller side. And this is something which Khalil also has to understand quickly as possible, because that's the length which gets you wicket. When the conditions are helpful, you got to pitch the ball up. You've seen it with Bhuvneshwar. You know, Bhuvneshwar, every time there is some help in the wicket, he'll make sure that he makes use of that those conditions. And different tracks, you err on a different side. Like, you know, on a good track, you look to err on the shorter side than fuller. Like, you don't mind being cut, because when you bowl the ball up on a flat track, it's a freebie. So that's something as a bowler you need to understand quickly. So on these kind of surfaces, you are on the fuller side. You know, you've seen it with Grand Daub also, who supported Trent Bolt beautifully. It was, even though he didn't have the pace, but because he was getting that length up and giving the ball that opportunity to and the batsman to entice to get into a shot, which was something proved rewardable.